Osteoporosis. Eat the following regularly. Almonds, black beans, broccoli, calcium enriched rice, milk or soy milk, collard greens, fish, flax seeds, green leafy vegetables, except spinach, kale, lentils, miso, molasses, milk, nuts, oysters, romaine, lettuce, sardines, with bones, sea vegetables, agar, nori, kombu, tempeh, and wakame, sesame seeds, shellfish, spinach, tofu, unsweetened cultured yogurt, walnuts, yogurt. A high salt intake has been linked to osteoporosis. Women who drank more than 14 glasses of milk a week had 45% more hip fractures than women who consumed one glass a week or less. Calcium from cow's milk is not well absorbed. You should avoid sugar, refined grains, and soda pops. You should reduce your intake of red meat, which may contribute to bone loss in some individuals. For osteoporosis, you need the following intake. Calcium 500 to 600 milligrams twice daily in divided doses. Magnesium 250 to 300 milligrams twice daily in divided doses. Vitamin D 800 to 1200 IU daily if you have osteoporosis, and 400 IU daily if you are supplementing vitamin D for prevention. Vitamin K1 is the form of vitamin K found in plants that is important for bone formation. Take 2 to 10 milligrams daily and up to 500 mcg daily for preventative purposes. Iprflavone 600 milligrams with food. Have your lymphocyte, a type of white blood cell, underscore levels monitored by your doctor when using this supplement. Essential fatty acids 4 grams of fish oil daily, along with 3000 milligrams of evening primrose oil. Strontium 680 milligrams daily. To maintain and build healthy bones. Eat the following. Almonds, asparagus, basil, bok choy, broccoli, Brussels sprouts, cabbage, cantaloupe, carrots, celery, cheese, cherries, eggs, fish, flax seeds, garlic, greens, kale, milk, miso, nuts, okra, onions, oranges, parsley, pork, potatoes, rhubarb, seeds, shellfish, soy, squash, tea, tofu, walnuts, water, drink a glass of water every 2 waking hours, wheat germ, wine, yogurt. Foods high in sulfur will help repair cartilage and bones. Restless leg syndrome. Restless leg syndrome is often associated with iron deficiency anemia. Eating iron-rich foods like red meat, nuts, and beans may help, but too much iron can be harmful, so have your iron levels checked by your doctor and don't take iron supplements without a doctor's advice. Sinusitis. During an acute infection, eat lightly and drink 1 glass of water every 2 waking hours, drink plenty of herbal teas, vegetable juices, and broths. For a powerful sinus drainage remedy, eat a small spoonful of crushed horseradish mixed with lemon juice. You may want to be near a sink or have a towel handy after taking this potent combination. If you must take an antibiotic for a sinus infection, be sure to consume a non-dairy source of friendly bacteria, such as kefir or sauerkraut. To alleviate sinusitis, consume the following. Alcohol cayenne chicken soup, especially with lots of vegetables, cold pressed oils, flax seeds, will reduce inflammation, add to cereals or salads, flaxseed oil, will reduce inflammation, take 1 teaspoon of oil every day, fresh fruits and vegetables, garlic, horseradish, kefir, onions, peaches, raw nuts and seeds, salt, severely restrict your intake, sauerkraut, watermelon, whole grains, oranges, garlic. Foods to avoid. Chocolate, dairy products, eggs, flours, refined fruit juices, fried and processed foods, sugar. To relieve a sinus headache and floaters from your eyes, take 2 grams of vitamin C every hour for about 16 hours. The number of hours depends on how bad your symptoms are. Diarrhea, indigestion, gastritis, nausea and stomachache ailments. Diarrhea. Eat the following. Applesauce, artichokes, bananas, rice, toast, yogurt. Indigestion. Eat the following. Artichoke, curry powder, ginger, mangoes, mint, pineapple, yogurt. Gastritis. Eat oat straw. Morning sickness and nausea. Eat grapes and watermelon. Motion sickness. Eat the following. Candied ginger, ginger tea, olives. Stomachache. Eat dried blueberries and mangoes. Eat a few tablespoons of dried blueberries. It has been reported that blueberries inhibit the ability of bacteria to stick to the inside of your body, which reduces the chance of a nasty infection in the lining of your stomach. Fresh or frozen berries may aggravate tummy troubles. Upset stomach. Eat mangoes and mint. Food poisoning. The most important thing is to keep hydrated by drinking 2 cups of liquid every waking hour. Try broths, electrolyte drinks, diluted fruit and vegetable juices, and water. Foods easy to digest are soups, broths, and steamed vegetables. You should stay away from dairy products, fats, and oils. Avoid sugar, caffeine, and alcohol. Once you begin to feel better, these foods tend to taste especially good. Apples, bananas, brown rice, carrots, cooked fruits, vegetables, soups. Stroke. If you're at a high risk for a stroke, especially with high blood pressure, which increases your odds, start eating at least 5 fruits and vegetables a day, especially citrus fruit and vegetables from the cabbage family, like Brussels sprouts. You can also consume apples, bananas, Brussels sprouts, cabbage, canola oil, cauliflower, eggs, figs, fish, ginger, grapefruit, kiwi fruit, nuts, onions, oranges, pumpkin, quinoa, squash, tea, watermelon, wheat germ, wine. Gums, mouth sores, teeth, throat, and tongue. Bleeding gums. For bleeding gums, take 20 mg of zinc and 500 mg of vitamin C daily. Eat a diet of natural foods and lots of vitamin C to help fight the deterioration of bones and infections of the gums, etc. Canker sores. Eat yogurt. To dry up and heal canker sores, hold a wet tea bag in your mouth over the canker sore, adjusting the bag from time to time for comfort, but keep it over the sore for at least 10 minutes. Dandelion tea may also heal cankers and prevent their return. For early treatment of canker sores, punch a hole in a vitamin E capsule and squeeze the gel directly on the ulcers as soon as they appear. This can be repeated from time to time until the sores are healed. A good gargle can work wonders too. Cold sores. Outbreaks of cold sores can be triggered by stress, which weakens the immune system. According to researchers, one of the best things you can do to keep away these painful sores is to relax. Teeth. Eat garlic and oranges. Garlic makes loose teeth take root again and removes tartar. Tooth decay. Eat cheese, drink tea, brush your teeth, and visit a dentist. Sore throat. While this is not a cure, it has been used to relieve the horrible pains of throat cancer. Violet leaf tea, used as a drink, mouthwash, or gargle. Use of this common tea is not permitted without a doctor's approval and is no substitute for qualified medical care. To make the violet leaf tea, use 2.5 ounces of fresh leaves of the Prince of Wales violet, the kind that grows wild or in your grandmother's garden, in a pint of boiling water. Don't use the General Herrick's variety, the large florist violets sold in nurseries as Viola odorata. Tongue soreness and burning remedy. To relieve soreness of the tongue, take large doses of vitamin C. To relieve a burning tongue, take a liver supplement along with vitamin B12 and riboflavin. Bad breath. Chew on a fennel seeds or munch on a sprig of parsley. Ulcers. Eat the following. Basil, chilies, cinnamon tea. Urinary tract infection. Eat blueberries and cranberries. Varicose leg ulcers. Make a poultice using comfrey. Put several big leaves through a juicer, dilute them, put the pulp on some gauze, and use this poultice just once a day for about 6 weeks. For diabetics, varicose vein, increase vitamin E to 3000 IUs and vitamin C to 2000 mg daily. Warts. Take 500 mg of olive leaf extract twice daily. Apply 1 drop of garlic oil to the warts twice daily for 4 weeks. Garlic oil has antiviral properties. Take 200 mcg of selenium daily. A selenium deficiency makes it easier for viruses to replicate. Take 400 IU of vitamin E daily. Vitamin E is important for immune function and to combat viral infections. Please note, I am not a doctor. I have compiled information to share with you. Any action you take based on the information provided to you in this publication is done at your own risk. I do not take any responsibility for your actions. Before you take any action, consult your doctor. Thank you for watching. Feel free to leave a comment down below, and please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.